Anybody, please? Hope you could hear my voice.
Sukhma Jeevi.
Hello? Anybody, please? Anybody, please?
Sukhma Jeevi.
Sukhma Jeevi.
It's creamy. So coming to the second one.
Yuga.
Name the virus. Which was explained.
Kaumudi, your voice is very low.
Kaumudi.
Yes, sir.
आप बिना उसके हेडफोन ईयरफोन के डायरेक्ट बोलेंगे तो शायद अच्छी आवाज आएगी.
डायरेक्ट बोलोगे तो
शायद अच्छी आवाज आएगी.
प्लीज
डोंट यूज
दो.
सर कैन कंटिन्यू.
नहीं नहीं याद आ गया आगे आ गया याद आ गया डॉक्टर अभी याद आ गया. इकट्ठे पेपर देते
थे. सो नेम द वायरस व्हिच सेज वशिष्ठ एक्सप्लेन्स लॉर्ड रामा अबाउट द स्टोरी ऑफ अ वायरस व्हिच अटैक्स द लंग्स लिवर हार्ट कॉजिंग पियर्सिंग पेन एंड डेथ. इट इज कर्कटी और विषुचिका. So from this it is evident that these viruses have been in existence right from the Vedic period as well as from the Treta Yuga, and now coming to the Dwapara Yuga, that is the Mahabharata, the bacteria and viruses described in Shanti Parva and Mahabharata, where it was given that there are many creatures that are so minute that their existence can only be inferred with the falling of the eyelids alone, they are destroyed. This is regarding bacteria and viruses described in Shanti Parva Mahabharata by. So who explained regarding these viruses? Yes, please.
Dharmaraja.
No, ma'am. It is Arjuna.
Ma'am, may I request everyone to please mute themselves? There is a lot of disturbance.
This is the second round.
Wherein ma'am will be telling about the epidemic. What it was.
Name this archaeological fact. One of the best preserved. Visualize the picture. Anybody?
For plague, it was constructed at.
It is a hamin manga. This is northeastern China. For 3000 BC. 5000 years ago. An epidemic wiped out. And the next and one is.
Anyone have any idea?
The first documented. Name the first documented.
Yes,
It is a small pox.
It is a small pox.
First one ever recorded.
First one ever recorded.
Severe.
Severe.
So the victims are
children.
Medical advice.
Medical advice is included.
Vulnerable people and out. And recovering from small.
Recovering from small.
Ingrained into rituals.
Ingrained into rituals.
It's quite interesting.
Quite actually. Interesting actually.
Like recorded
like
history.
Recorded history.
But this is first epidemic.
First epidemic.
And now,
quarantine.
Every time. So, can anybody say the
first
Tuesday?
Quarantine.
Sex season.
Drama.
Yes, please, anybody?
Third quarantine was
In which epidemic? It is during the 14th. The practice of quarantine.
They were kept in for 14.
The ships that were arriving.
So that it was third quarantine.
The first epidemic disease, this act we are continuing even for better prevention of
epidemic.
So there was not much changes.
Started feeding rate.
So when did it start? Anybody?
Madam, your question is breaking, ma'am. You're not getting properly, madam. Please be loud, ma'am.
Ma'am, the sound must be coming.
The sound must be coming. There are two systems which are participating in the webinar.
Yes, anybody answer, please?
Now please check. Sir, this is a viewpoint. Dr. Kaumudi, yes sir.
Am I audible now, sir? Yes, audible, ma'am. We are getting now.
Now you can go ahead. The first epidemic, this is the question twice, madam, so then you can get the question. I could hear more clouds. And first, Sandri conflict in Paris. During which epidemic?
Fear of being overcome.
Now my audio is clear.
Hello. you please, I request you to mute yourself, otherwise keep yourself muted.
Please mute yourself.
Dr. Kaumudi, start now.
Okay, sir. The modern transportation. Modern transportation has a global outbreak. Anybody? It is the Russian flu of 1889, where because of the railroads which are laid down, because of the connectivity, the Russian flu of 1899 became so virulent that it struck Europe because of the railroads. That is the 19th century Russian flu outbreak. Next, first mechanical ventilators. When they started? First mechanical ventilators. Any idea? Anybody? So this is with the polio, where we can't even think of or imagine, or generally we think of respiratory disorder. The first time a disease or the source was discovered, the first isolation of insulin, when it was done, it was the virus. It was in 1931. Who described influenza first? Yes, please. Is nothing but Hippocrates. He's the first person who described influenza. And which epidemic, that is plague, is called as plague of Galen? You all know about Galen. This plague is also called as plague of Galen. It is Antonine plague. Yes, please. I think who answer?
And
yes, ma'am. Your good name?
Antonine plague.
Okay. Yes, it's you are absolutely right, madam. It is Antonine plague. And next, the founder of epidemiology. Who is the founder? Gave a good beginning, ma'am. Yes, anybody? Because we have announced
prizes.
Small token of
gift.
sir? Yes? Yes. Anybody? Yes, Prakash Tokas. He is the first person who did a lot of research on epidemiology. And next question, who is the father of modern epidemiology? Anybody? Father of modern epidemiology. Yes, please. Father of
Edward Jenner. Edward Jenner.
No, sir. Anyone wants to take a chance? Second chance? He is nothing but John Snow. As we said earlier, like the cholera epidemic, the water pump, the source of cholera, he is the person who is behind that. And till now, we finished the second round with the first events in the history of epidemics. Now, coming to the round three.
The third round is basically the worst pandemics. Ma'am will talk about all the worst pandemics so far.
The most fatal pandemic in recorded history was. This is the most fatal pandemic in recorded history. Anybody? This picture is collected from the London Museum of Archaeology. This picture is evident. How fatal it is.
Black fever.
Plague.
Yes, it is a black. It is the most lethal epidemic. This wiped out over the half. And changed the course of You're absolutely right. And now. This is the flu. Deadliest flu. That was the deadliest pandemic. Which was the deadliest pandemic. The world has.
Corona.
Spanish flu.
It is Spanish flu. One person answer, please. One finishes. Kindly unmute. It is a Spanish flu. Till date, this is the deadliest flu. It was caused by H1N1 virus in the year 1918. And this is almost an easiest question. The epidemic of Indian origin, purely Indian origin. From India, it spread all over the world. Anybody? And it is the most deadliest of all diseases of 19th century.
Plague, madam? Plague?
No, ma'am. Anybody?
It happened in Kerala.
It is cholera. It symbolized because of illiteracy, poverty, filth, underdevelopment, which was enormous during the time of 19th centuries. So from India, it spread all over the world. So cholera, this is the Indian origin. Next, this is a pandemic by late 20th century. This is the most easiest question, I think so.
Corona? H1N1?
No, ma'am. Anybody?
Spanish flu.
Mute yourself again.
So the answer is 8. This is the pandemic of 20th century. Identified. And the next question. Is a flu where 80% was young girls and
Doctor Renuka, I request you to mute your Renuka. Your mic is disturbing all. Please keep yourself muted. Yes, Dr. Kaumudi, start now.
Okay. COVID V2.
So, flu pandemic where 80% of deaths occurs in young adults and children. Anybody? Now we can unmute and answer. And again, please mute. Yes, please. Anybody swine? Can answer?
Swine flu?
Yes, it's the right answer. Swine flu. The next. The epidemic which attacks infants or babies in womb, causing birth defects. This is a virus or epidemic which is not at all harmful to adults, but it attacks infants.
Japanese encephalitis?
No.
Japanese encephalitis?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Chikavirus.
Babies in womb causing microcephaly. And least severe flu pandemic till date. This is the least severe flu pandemic among all the flu pandemics. This is the least severe. Yes, please. I'm showing the map. I'm giving a hint and clue also. You all just watch carefully. You can get the answer. Anybody?
Avian flu.
Yes, it's the right answer.
Avian flu.
Anything is okay. So next. The world's longest pandemic.
Mom plague.
No. Anybody? Have a second.
HIV, madam?
It is cholera.
Cholera.
And this, I think everyone can answer. This is the completely eradicated.
Smallpox.
Which one is completely eradicated till date?
Smallpox is the right answer.
And now? We came to the round four.
Round four is a little research based.
So now, researchers have found that these viruses have been in existence since the first vertebrates existed. So we have seen from the Vedic times, Dwapariga, Tretayuga, and when it comes to the scientific aspect, the viruses have been in existence since the first vertebrates existed. So the researchers have found that. What type of viruses? Anybody? What type of viruses that the researchers have been found that they are existed since the time of the first vertebrates? Which type of viruses I'm asking? Type of viruses. Not the name of the epidemic. It is a type of viruses. Yes, please. Just can, you can try. There's nothing wrong in trying. Anybody? Okay, then the marks goes to the quiz master. That is the RNA viruses. So researchers say that for the first time it has been found that RNA viruses, where the genome allele is RNA rather than DNA, have been existent since the first vertebrates existed. Now coming to the virology part. This is one of the world's first epidemics offered an early glimpse at a key tenet of virology. Here you have to name the epidemic. Yes, please. Are you able to hear me?
Yes, madam. Yes, yes.
Okay. So this is the world's first epidemics offered an early glimpse at a key tenet of virology. Shall I answer?
Yes, please.
Is actually plague. It opened for the key tenet of opening. Next. So we all experienced work from home, isn't it? So when it started, let's have a look on that. Work from home. There are two famous people who had victories from work from home. Shakespeare used to write poetry when the theaters were shut down. Similarly, we all are familiar with Sir Isaac Newton, who used an opportunity when his hostel was closed. He came back to his home and he sat near the apple tree, and this paved for the fundamental law of physics. So during which pandemic these two persons gave to the new world the work from home, they took an advantage this period? Can anybody?
Spanish flu.
No, it is the Black Death, the period of Shakespeare, that is the 14th century. So during 1347 to 1351, because of the Black Death, which was in vogue for these many years, the hostels were closed, the theaters were shut down. As we already discussed, the entire world was closed. They have to come back home. And this inspired them to pave for the new history. Next, quarantine. The emergence of early quarantine measures and check border points. When it started? Emergence of early quarantine measures and check the border points. All the borders were closed and they took all the precautions, the quarantine measures and quarantine measures.
During cholera?
No. It is first influenza pandemic.
Spanish influenza.
Influenza pandemic. And coming to the contact tracing. Now everyone is struggling a lot. So the first key insight on contact tracing, when it started, during which epidemic the key insights on contact tracing started? You can name the epidemic, it's enough. You need not name the year also. The key insights on contact tracing. Yes, anybody? Yes, please. So I am going ahead. Hello. It is cholera pandemic.
Corona itself.
Pandemic. It is a cholera pandemic. As we discussed already with the Dr. John Snow, the father of modern epidemiology. And coming to the social distance, this pandemic revealed how many lives can be saved from social distancing. That social distancing.
Spanish flu.
Yes, it's the right answer. This epidemic has implanted awareness into the medical community and general public the importance of immune system. What is a pandemic?
HIV.
Yes, it's the right answer.
HIV. It's the right answer.
So prior to the emergence of AIDS, AIDS is the right answer. And coming to the tracking, we all know about RO number. That is a reproduction number of two spreads. So RO number is highest in which epidemic or in which virus, whatever it is, you can answer. There is no problem. RO number is highest. Basing on this, we can track the infectiousness. RO number is
swine flu. Swine flu.
No. One more answer we are getting. It's not swine flu. Yes, please. Someone said another answer. Okay. It is Rho number is highest.
And.
Can anybody identify this? This is the first PPE kit. So can anybody name the epidemic? Which epidemic? During which epidemic this PPE kits was first started to protect themselves? We already discussed mechanical ventilators and all, and now these are the PPE kits. And this picture, the right side picture now, this is what PPE kits now we are, what we are using. Earlier they were leather jackets. Anybody?
Spanish flu? Spanish flu?
No, ma'am. It is plague. During 15th and 16th century, he is a plague doctor. The leather costume. And coming to the round five now.
Round five is about revolutions.
Every pandemic created a revolution in the history. So let us all just go through once. Coming to the first one is a depopulation. It was the start of one of the greatest depopulation events in the history of mankind. So what is the epidemic? This epidemic was the start of one of the greatest depopulation events in the history of mankind. Any guess what? From the pictures, you can have a clue also. Yes, anybody? It is smallpox. Now the Mexico, what we are seeing, it is because of the depopulation events in the history of mankind. And next is the vote for women. It started in the United States. So this epidemic provided an opportunity for women to take on leadership roles and eventually led to the passage of 19th Amendment in the United States that gave the women the right to vote. In the year 1915, this was a clue for you all. Yes? Anybody?
The First World War. Provided opportunity.
Vote for women. Yes, someone are trying? Yes?
It was during First World War.
Yeah, First World War.
HIV?
Spanish flu.
Spanish
flu. It's the right answer we are giving. But it is because of the Spanish flu, during the World War and because of the Spanish flu, many people, they have lost their lives, especially men. So the women had the right to vote during that period. Now coming to the end of the feudalism, the Europe's transition to the modern world. This had a great fluidity in the economy and some historians believed it hasn't the end of the feudal system. The rise of the nation states. What is the epidemic or pandemic? This paved for the end of the feudalism. Yes?
Cholera. Cholera, madam?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
It is Black Death.
It's Black Death.
So in the, this is one of the convulsive events in the European history. Because of that, causes great deprived in the economy. And this led to the end of the feudal system. You're all familiar with Christopher Columbus. And we all know the history also. But let us see how far it is he is related with the epidemic. So this epidemic changed the future of America after the era of Christopher Columbus at the end of 15th century. What is the epidemic? This epidemic changed the future of America. So when he entered, when he discovered America, we all know that Christopher Columbus discovered America. So after his arrival at the end of 15th century, it changed the future of America. Not in a positive way because of the epidemic. He carried the epidemic with him. So what is the epidemic? Any idea?
Black Death? Black Death?
No. It is smallpox. It's still even today. States have gotten rid of Columbus Day. And slave rebellion. So this epidemic is the biggest slave rebellion in human history. This agreement is the biggest slave rebellion in human history. Any try? Hello, people. Till now, we didn't had any question regarding this. This is the first one. This yellow fever. Next, the industrial revolution. Earlier we had the slave rebellion. Now it is industrial revolution. Where this epidemic paved the way for the modernization of the West. So this is an epidemic of industrial revolution, but thrived on social tension also helped to create. Any idea?
Cholera.
Cholera.
Yes.
Yes. Right answer.
Cholera is the right answer.
Yes. And Roman Empire.
Roman Empire.
This contributed to the Roman Empire. It is also called as Roman. What is that? Which disease is called as Roman? And it was named
because
the decline of Roman Empire.
Has anybody?
This is very famous as
Roman.
And
malaria.
And WHO declared that. Many of the epidemics are because and leaving lot of clues. Anybody want to try? Okay, malaria is the right answer. Yes. Is George Washington? We all know he is a very famous personality. So, but even though as a president, he has to flew from the city of Philadelphia because of this epidemic. Any idea? George Washington had fled the city Philadelphia from one of this largest epidemics. You have a clue from the letters as well as the background pic also. A small clue I am giving. Any idea? Anybody? It is nothing but yellow fever.
Yellow fever.
In Philadelphia.
Philadelphia.
It was the very largest pandemic, so the president himself has to fly from the city. He has to escape. And coming to this, I hope every one of us played in our childhood. Ringa, ringa, roses. Is it not? The old English nursery rhyme, ringa, ringa, roses. This reminds us of the symptoms of this epidemic.
Cholera.
What is that epidemic?
One is cholera, someone
else. Cholera.
No. Anybody?
Display.
A fragrant herbs and
flowers.
Please the cup.
We all
fall. Like all are dead. Display. And the pandemic left many people in the lives of many people. Here is one example. Named Mary Mallon. For more than a fact of her life. This epidemic is synonymous. The stigma produced in the term of life. What is that pandemic? After her, even famous. Yes? Yes, please. Any idea? So I'm giving the answer.
Cholera.
Okay.
It's typhoid.
It
will famous as the typhoid. And Mahatma Gandhi. What is the pandemic? Yes, please. Any idea?
Madam, cholera. It is cholera.
No, ma'am.
He is Spanish flu.
So his grandson. Ever. 1918. This is a picture of Mahatma Gandhi.
When he was sick with the Spanish.
And this was American President.
Dr. Roosevelt.
This is Memorial in Washington.
Memorial in Washington, 1916.
New York City. What is the pandemic? And among the entire US citizens, he was the main sufferer. He was also one of the victims. Anybody?
Spanish flu?
1916.
Yes, ma'am, it is Spanish flu.
No.
No.
Anyone wants to have
trial? Plague.
Yellow fever?
No. Is polio. And from the beginning of the is the only physical disabled person in the United States. He was a victim of polio. And Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. He was the handling of this.
He became a crown of achievement.
What is that pandemic? Yes?
It is plague, madam.
Yes, it's the right answer. Plague. During the 1917 plague epidemic. So had keen understanding of the people's pain, and he was victimized with plague also. And because of his dedicated service, even before he became Sardar, he was given this title. Next, Bal Gangadhar Tilak. He was an editor, we all know. So he was charged with sedition. This is the dark past of the Epidemic Act. The writings as editor of the newspaper during this pandemic again is the British rule. What is the pandemic?
Cholera, madam.
No. Spanish flu.
Yes, it's the right answer. So the British themselves
For 18 months.
Yes, nothing but bargain. And
this is the paper.
Revolutionized against this pandemic. So what is the outcome of the research? A lot of myths. We can treat it. But sorry for a bit delay. Now coming to our part, that is the knowledge of medicine part. The vital role what homeopathy has played right from the discovery of homeopathy from Hahnemann till date. So coming to the round one, this is the philosophy part. The first question, one man catches scarlet fever from another man, but catches it because he is minor to the disease, which to him his neighbor does not catches it, his friend passes it by as no concern of his. This is from the philosophy part. Yes, on which topic or whose words are these? Yes, could you will hear me please?
Ma'am, question is not clear.
Pardon?
Ma'am, question is not clear. Can you please repeat?
Okay, okay. See, one man catches an epidemic disease, whatever it is, from another man. But another person may not get it. Because one is major, one is having enough strength, one is having not. His neighbor does not catch it. Why?
Mom,
because of susceptibility. But from which philosophy?
Which philosophy?
It is Robert. Yes, it's Vyagaming as a writer. Yes, now coming to the second. Don't think that it is a lengthy part for us. if an epidemic comes up, you come down with it. Some people are protected. Many physicians, searching the things that made the patient. So this is unique. Until the remedy is found. This is said by? Whose words are these? Generally we ask
many
questions. This class was said that we were for the cause of yes. But what we have to do? During epidemic.
Yes, please.
Actually, you are not clear with the question.
Yes.
Shall I proceed? It is by applicant. The first, you can say either the cause whose words are these, or if at all you say both, you'll be awarded more marks, a bonus marks. From which philosophy and on which topic? Yes, please. The transmission of the disease from various aspects. Now we are hearing nowadays with COVID, we don't touch this, the virus stays this forever longer period and all. Dr. Hanuman says only one word for that. What is that?
Master.
Contagions. Contagions.
Contagions is not the answer.
I'm
giving a clue.
What?
One word. It is miasms. But explain to Dr.
Close.
Doing all these
apps.
It is from the Stuart Close
philosophy.
On the general pathology.
And
now coming.
System
of the structure.
Let us see what.
Experience regarding
epidemic.
So coming to the first part. Only means on which we can
check
the separation of
the
disease. We have to break the chain. Whose words are these?
Yes, please.
Anybody? It is a homoeopathic part.
Please try.
After this, we have a therapeutic. But in the initial stage,
said
about epidemics.
Shall I go further?
Hello, this is the voice.
Please set it.
And now, coming to the causes of symptoms. This Talbot, he said that whatever the disease may be, we need not know the name of the disease, or we can even treat whatever the disease which we never heard before. Whose words are these? Because we take cognizance of symptoms, whether indicative of any disease or not, whether it is known or not. So we can correct it itself before the disease results, definite disease results. What is that? Who said that?
Dr. Hanuman.
No. Already I asked for just before question of Hanuman, and You can't expect that I'll ask the same question again. Isn't it?
Ma'am, Dr. Kent.
Sir. Dr. Harry.
One answer, please.
Dr. Kent.
No.
Dr. Harry.
It is Dr. Harrington.
Harry.
Okay. So next. Sorry, answer revealed first. Anyhow, I'm reading this. So in epidemics, whether it is of unknown origin or the outbreaks, whatever it is, we have to stick on to the principles and the fundamental laws remain the firm and intact, and they are the basic to provide a sure guide to health. During epidemics, these are the golden words of Dr. H.R. Roberts. Because already I pressed the answer first, sorry. And here comes a very good statement by a stalwart who said that we have to do a lot of hard work, because we should not give any remedy because they are in the list. We have thousands of remedies and we can't give any remedy because they are in the list. And if you do drudgery in the beginning of an epidemic, that is, if we run against the list of the medicines and the prescribing of your cases will be rapid, and your remedies, they abort cases of sickness, make malignant cases very simple, that the classification would be impossible, and stop the typhoid course in a week and cure MD fevers in a day. So we should not hurry up in the treatment. We must do a lot of hard work, especially in case of epidemics. Whose words are these? Yes?
Ma'am, Dr. Boger?
No, it is Dr. Kent. Next, if one man's meat is another man's poison, same way with the medicine also. It is like with the individualization part in the case of epidemic. Each patient requires a treatment specially adapted to his particular constitution and to his actual condition. Whose words are these?
I'm Dr. Hanneman.
We have a lot of stalwarts.
Madam, A. Robert.
And previous clinical experience is very much essential during epidemics. What he said, that we have to record each and every symptom, the previous clinical experience, so that if we maintain a record, it will be useful for further. Pardon? So this point is advisable of keeping careful records not only of the symptoms but also the treatment, potency, number of doses, whatever it is. Every detail we have to make a record so that it will be useful in the future for next cases. It will be an experience. Whose words are these? Yes? These are the golden words. That's why I kept as the gems of wisdom. It's a Gibson Miller. Next, the first prescription, especially this was given in a case of diphtheria. The first prescription, when it is correctly chosen, will most likely, so we must go to bad from worse, and the next prescription must be a guesswork only. And so the case will end in mortality. Anybody? The first prescription, is it visible for you? Question?
Dr. Kent?
No. No? Yes, anybody? Sorry, please. Repeat. I think you said Dr. Kent.
Dr. Kent.
Yes, it's the right answer. Sorry, because of the technical issue, actually I was looking at it. Okay. Dr. Kent is the right answer. So next question is, many says that we can treat with homeopathy anything like from cold to cancer, but even we have limitations in our system of medicine. Whose words are these? We have numerous evidences that homeopathy can be treated against many pandemics, but due to legal barriers and laws, we couldn't do that much service what we want to do. But in addition to that, we should not say that we can treat everything and anything. We have some limitations. Whose words are these? He is a contemporary homeopath. A small clue I am giving. Anybody?
Dr. Clark.
Pardon?
Dr. Clark.
No, he is a contemporary homeopath. We are living with him now. A small clue I am giving.
L.M. Khan.
It is correct, dear master. And the development of pneumonia is a rare occurrence if a good homeophysician was called during the first 24 hours of attack. This is very much useful nowadays during the COVID time. Well, any homeopath, we can treat within 24 hours, the development of pneumonia can be arrested. Whose words are these? Whose experience is this? Anybody? It is Dr. Adha Grima. And now coming to the round two. Yes, I think we can, you all can answer snapshot. Patapat answering. This is like a keynote prescribing in case of epidemics. Coming to the therapeutic part, this remedy was specific for pink eye during the influenza epidemic.
Balana?
For pink eye during the influenza epidemic.
So, rhino?
Balana?
No, it is a pink eye, it is not the red eye. It is arthiod by Dr. Clark. And next, this is the epidemic remedy for children 2 to 10 years. What is the remedy? Specific remedy for epidemic remedy for children, especially 2 and 10 years of age.
Belladonna?
No.
Tacina?
No. Tacina, a children remedy. Next. This remedy has proved of great value to patients who, after an attack of influenza, they have a feeling that they would never be well again. Whose words are these? Sorry, what is the remedy? Never well again. After an attack of influenza, they feel that they would never be well again. Yes? Any trial? Is a simple remedy?
Arsenic.
Is it China? And the most common homeopathic prescription in 1918 for H5N1 is?
Ipecac.
Arsenic.
Selenium.
No. Arsenic is not the answer.
Epidotorium perf.
No.
Gelsemium and Ipecac.
Gelsemium.
Only one answer, please. Gelsemium is the right answer. It's not Ipecac, only Gelsemium is the right answer. That is why I started with the history, and now whatever we are going through, this knowledge of medicine, homeopathy has proved its efficacy in all those pandemics, what you went through all the pandemics in the history. And coming to the psychology part during epidemics, fear of cholera. Cholerophobia, that is the fear and dislike of cholera or being infected with cholera. What is the remedy? Yes? What is the remedy? Fear of cholera, cholerophobia. Yes?
Calcarea?
No.
Calcarea, madam?
No, no, it is arsenic album.
No.
It is arsenic. And fear of impending disease or contagious or epidemic infection, please name the rubric from the complete repertory. Tell the main rubric, is enough. Need not tell the sub rubrics also.
Fear of contagious diseases.
Pardon?
It is fear of contagious diseases.
If a line of
fear of contagious diseases.
But it is actually mind, fear, disease of or anxiety impending contagious disease, epidemic infection. It's a 50% correct answer, it's no problem. And coming to the round three, it is an interesting round, especially for homeopaths. This is a DD of remedies, differential diagnosis of remedies. As with a simple thing, we have to, like, never been well since influenza, never been well since pneumonia. We have to tell two remedies. Never been well since influenza, never been well since pneumonia. With a slight difference, we can have the remedies.
Ma'am, lobelia.
For which one?
Ma'am, pneumonia.
Then for what about influenza?
Ma'am.
China. It's China, madam.
China. Sorry, Syncona.
Yeah, whatever it is. China or Syncona is the same. But
yes, ma'am, yes.
If we answer both, we are giving a bonus mark, like, when we consider
regarding. Okay, ma'am.
For each question 20-20, and if at all you answer both, we are giving 50 marks, 10 bonus marks. So are you clear that your answer is right answer? I am going to the right answer. Sorry to say that it's your wrong answer. It is influenza and calica. Never been well since influenza, it is influenza. And never been well since pneumonia, it is calica. And here, dash is to measles. Here you have to, the dash you have to name the remedy. Dash is to measles, just what belladonna is to scarlatina. Same way, dash is to smallpox, what gelsemium is to bilious fever. Yes? These are the commonest remedies only. Just you have to think, that's it.
Pulse, madam, pulse tilla.
Pulsatilla.
Pulse tilla.
Is to measles. Is to measles.
Measles, madam.
Next one.
For measles, it is pulse, madam.
Okay. Next one. For smallpox.
Hydrastis.
No. Both are wrong. It is. One is right. It is pulsatilla is right, but sarracenia is wrong. Next. This remedy is specific in gastric flu and epidemic influenza, and this is a scutula specific for epidemic influenza. Yes?
Calimmune.
Sajra's remedy is Calimmune, madam.
Calimmune.
Specific gastric flu for
scutula specific, madam. It is a biochemic, scutula specific.
Calimmune, madam.
Calimmune.
No, and coming to the differential diagnosis of the remedies with the repertory part. Till now we have gone through Medicare Medica part. So with the pathology, if at all we consider meningitis, desire for company during meningitis, you have to name the remedy, and aversion to company during meningitis. What is the remedy?
Belladonna tuberculum.
No.
Belladonna tuberculum.
No. It is lycopodium and gelsemium. Lycopodium desired company during meningitis, and gelsemium company aversion to during meningitis. And next, coming to the cholera part, diarrhea frequent during cholera epidemic. Name the remedy, and dysentery frequent during cholera epidemic. Diarrhea, frequent diarrhea during cholera epidemic, and dysentery frequent during cholera epidemic. What is the remedy? Two remedies. Yes, please. Anybody? Diarrhea remedies and dysentery remedies.
Viretra, ma'am.
Yes?
Viretra, ma'am.
Dr. Sanjeev, please, a bit louder.
Veratrumbel.
For which one?
For diarrhea during cholera.
No, it is phosphorus for diarrhea.
Madam, any minus points are there, madam?
Pardon?
Madam?
No, any minus points are there attempting? No, no. No minus marks.
No negative marks.
You are liberty to answer. Okay. And I gave the reference with the repertories also. This is from the general repertory, the chapter of anus and rectum and stool, diarrhea, dysentery, phosphorus and pulse tiller. And coming to the diphtheria part, just as we have seen meningitis, same way with desires company during diphtheria and company aversion during diphtheria. What are the remedies? No minus marks, yeah, it's like a fun say. See, in the form of quiz, I want to present before you all in the form of research regarding epidemics, the history of epidemics and the role of homeopathy, the efficacy of homeopathy during epidemics and pandemics. We are at free liberty to answer. Yes, please.
Pulsilla netamur, madam.
No.
It is lac netamur.
No, no. It is lac cananum who desires company and natrum mass company aversion to. It is from the nervous repertory. Okay. Now coming to the next part of the thing, it is the regarding the pathology part. With reference to Metria Manica. First is with the poliomyelitis. And with the picture itself, we can answer the question. I need not give a hint.
Lethyrus.
It is gelsemia.
Pothos, madam.
It is gelsemia, ma'am. You can see the plant. I gave the picture. It is like matching. Okay, so coming to the whooping cough, what is the remedy?
Drosera?
Yes.
Drosera.
And coming to the next one, typhoid fever?
Baptisia?
No, please go ahead. I'm giving a small clue. Please go, don't go through the typhoid remedies. We don't even expect that this remedy works for typhoid fever. When gastric and typhoid symptoms, they are predominant and epidemic occurring in winter and early spring. This works wonders as a genus epidemicus. What is the remedy? Yes, please. You can identify from the picture itself the clue. It's an antintat. No one that antintat works wonders in a case of typhoid. Dr. HCL, and you can have a reference from him. Next, coming to the influenza. What is the remedy? This is works wonders now. When arsenic has failed.
Influenza.
Yes?
Influenza.
Pardon?
Influenza?
No. Influenza, we can't see great prostration. Here, great prostration is a characteristic feature in the violent form of influenza.
China, madam? China?
It is carcolactic acid. Madam, I have given the picture. You can match. That is a clue. Okay? It is carcolactic acid. I'm coming to the bubonic plague. Yes. This, I think, anyone can answer? These two remedies, they work wonders during the bubonic plague. What are the two remedies?
Laxus and Naja.
Yes, it's the right answer. Laxus and Naja, this was given by Dr. Clark. And Lagripi, which we have seen. What is the remedy?
Euphotorium part?
Yes, given by Dr. Nash. And coming to the epidemic dysentery, what is the remedy? for epidemic dysentery during hot climates?
Camphor?
No. See the pick? The remedy pick I have given.
Merkzol?
Merkzol is the right answer.
Merkzol.
And coming to the cholera, this remedy gives instantaneous relief. It's given in the first stages of cholera.
Lethyrus.
Cesium.
Cholera remedy, cholera remedy. You can see the plant. It's one of the trials of cholera. It's camphor by Dr. Hahnemann. That was a statement given by Dr. Hahnemann. So coming to the round five, this is also pathology round, but here you have to name the chapter in the repertory given. The first one is a smallpox in the boric repertory. Where you'll find? Name the chapter, it's enough. Smallpox.
Skin.
Wrong answer, it is fever. Boric repertory, fever chapter, exanthemata, erective fever, variola, smallpox. I have given in the chart also. And coming to the yellow fever of the Kent repertory. In which chapter you'll see yellow fever? This is evident that in homeopathy we have a solution for all epidemic diseases and pandemic diseases. That
extremities?
Is yes.
Extremities?
No.
Generalities?
Generalities.
Fever. But chippan ga the fever.
In polio, next poliomyelitis from the complete repertory. In which chapter you'll see?
Extremities.
No.
Extremities, madam.
No, it is generalities, paralysis, poliomyelitis. Dengue fever. Dark repertory. Yes? Dengue fever from Clark repertory. Fast.
Clark, no idea, madam. Fever, madam?
No. It is clinical. We have only three chapters in Clark repertory. That is a clinical chapter. We'll find direct clinical dengue fever. Encephalitis. Warning Hassan's repertory.
Head.
Yes. Can you explain a bit in detail? Head. Next. Hair. Agency. Head, internal inflammation, encephalitis. Of course, it's the right answer for you because I asked only the chapter. And coming to the bubonic plague and the boric repertory, where you'll see? Bubonic plague, where you'll see? So we can find all the
differences.
Yes?
Fevers, madam.
Generalities. Yeah. And Russian flu, Russian influenza from the gentry repertory. Gentry repertory of concordances. Where you see? In which chapter?
Nose.
Okay. If you answer one more, we'll give a bonus marks. Because we can have in two chapters.
From respiratory.
Pardon?
Respiratory.
It is larynx and trachea. Or voice, larynx and trachea, we can find this.
Larynx and trachea.
Yeah, epidemic or Russian influenza. Typhoid fever, country country.
Typhoid.
Generalities.
Gastric, madam.
Pardon?
Gastric means it's rectum. Rectum.
Repertory, if you don't go to the fever chapter, fever, continuing fever, typhus, typhoid. And now, coming to the round six. So, we found that the vaccination is the only solution. And let's see what homeopathy says, or homeopath says, or Stalwart says about vaccination. And ailments from vaccination, where you find in the country pottery? side effects are ailments from vaccination, very fine.
Alicia? Ailments.
Yes? Ailments from vaccination. Yes, sir, please.
Puja.
No, I am asking the chapter.
Generality.
Madam, it is in general, it is.
Generality.
It is generalities.
Generalities.
Can generalities vaccination after? And coming to the side effects of vaccination, this is a single remedy. That is nausea after vaccination or convulsions after vaccination. For both it works. A single remedy. What is that remedy?
Tuja?
No. Anybody?
Secuta? Secuta, no. Madam.
It is silesia. Can stomach nausea vaccination after? Same way with can generalities convulsions vaccination after. Silesia is the only remedy. The single remedy. And beautiful curative work can be done in many chronic conditions arising from vaccination or by taking vaccinosis with this remedy. What is the remedy?
Tuja. Tuja, madam. Tuja.
Yes, Tuja is the remedy. This is an antidote to vaccination. Is the right answer. Coming to the genus Epidemics part. So the solution for vaccination, we as homeopaths, we show that the genus Epidemics is a wonderful remedy. So let us see what Stalwart said about this. The use of homeopathic remedies as genus Epidemics and homeoprophylaxis began by, who began that? The use of homeopathic remedies as
genus
Epidemics. Yes?
Hahnemann. Hahnemann, madam.
And Dr. Hahnemann first used the word genus epidemicus. In which year or to whom he spoke the first word of genus epidemicus? With whom he discussed? If you say both answers, you will be given a bonus mark.
1840s, madam. 1840s.
No. And with whom he discussed? He revealed
it is
first.
1798.
No. 1798 is too early.
Okay.
It is 1831.
Okay.
So, is it Dr. Hahnemann?
I have given the near, ma'am. I have given the year, madam.
No,
it is 1840s, I said, madam.
It is not 1840s. This is a specific year, 1831, where he discussed with AJD and he conversated and he used the term genus epidemics for the first time. And who said this? The most important and general rule in homeopathy is, in especially epidemics of acute diseases, it is often necessary to treat the disease first. And in the epidemics, there is a kind of epidemic genus so that all the patients require the same medicine.
Erring, madam. Erring.
Pardon?
Erring. Erring. Erring, madam.
No, ma'am. It's the wrong answer. No. It's not herring. It is Fortia Bernoulli. And the genus epidemicus is a remedy that covers the totality of the existing malady, not all the symptoms of which are to be found in any one patient. So if you do not find this, your treatment is nothing but the palliative and does not fulfill the law. Whose words are these? So you must cover the entire totality, otherwise it is only a palliative. Whose words are these regarding genus epidemicus?
Ma'am, Dr. Kent.
No. Any other trials? Anyone? It is Dr. H.C. Allen. And this homeopath suggested lay practitioners to use camphor as a single genus epidemicus remedy for the treatment of cholera affected patients. Who? Yes, please. cholera for the treatment of cholera, camphor as a single genus epidemics remedy. Dr. Bernie Hassan. And a leading representative of 19th century, he is very famous, we all know him pretty well right from our student age. A map leading to the eye of the hurricane or how to actually find the epidemic genes. So for everything, there is an eye just as you see in a hurricane. What is that? Who said that? Yes? Who said that? Yes, please. Anybody? Just as there is an eye for a hurricane, like that we have. Genus epidemics is the eye for the epidemics. Yes?
Bonin Hassan?
It is Richard Hughes. We call, this is called as Hughes filter. We filter all the remedies and we come to a conclusion of a genus epidemics. Next. Coming to the next part of the thing, it is round 7. That is the prophylactics in homeopathy. It's an important part. So homeopathic prophylaxis began with this epidemic. What is that epidemic?
Cholera, madam.
Part. I'll finish it off, sir. We are in the last part.
In how much time?
Yeah, I think 5 more minutes.
Fine.
Cholera, madam.
Dengue.
Yes, fever.
Dengue.
That is the clinical observation of. And can you match? This is a prophylactic for polio. This is matching. Name the remedy.
Letheras.
Letheras sativa.
Letheras sativa. Yes, is the right answer. And this one. Hope you could identify the disease.
Baldona.
Veratrum.
Baldona, madam. It is Baldona.
Yes, Baldona is the right answer, Baldona. But. What is the disease? It is a prophylactic for
measles.
It is a scarlet
fever. Erysipels.
It is a scarlet fever. Well known as for scarlet fever. And this one? This is a prophylactic as well as disinfectant.
Eucalyptus.
Yes,
eucalyptus, madam.
For? It is an epidemic influenza. It is a preventive as well as a disinfectant for epidemic influenza. By Dr. Clark, he gave that. And for cholera, this is the best preventive remedy. What is that?
Cupramet. Cupramet. Cupramet.
Cupram.
Cupram sulf.
It is a cupram acetic. It is not sulfate, cupram aceticum.
Aceticum.
Yeah.
Aceticum.
And all IHMs are well aware of great personality. Anybody? Who is he?
Lumbum Metallicum.
Calcutta based doctor.
GLN Shastri.
Yes, GLN Shastri is the right answer.
Yes, GLN Shastri.
He has been called as the father of BCT therapy for Japanese encephalitis. And that is we are capable of quickly checking a disease in its onset must be its best predictive. Whose words are these? A remedy that is capable of quickly checking a disease in its onset must be its best preventive. Whose words are these? Yes? Yes, please. It is Dr. Hanneman. Hey.
Dr. Hanneman.
Yes. And this, the selection of the prophylactic remedy must to some extent be governed by the nature of the epidemic. And therefore, the best preventive cannot always be. Determined until the epidemic has appeared. And its peculiar nature has been ascertained. Whose words are these? selection of the prophylactic remedy must to some extent be governed by the nature of epidemic. Therefore, the best preventive cannot always be determined until the epidemic has appeared and its peculiar nature has been ascertained. Whose words are these? I am going with the answer. Coral Dunham. And the most noble role of medicine is unquestionably prophylaxis. Is it not? So who said that? There, homeopathy asserts its superiority over the existing methods. It can prevent the disease without endangering the organism, without incurring the disappointments of the
prevention. Kent, madam. Kent.
It's Pierce Kent.
Yes, ma'am.
And it is the duty of the physician to take very close observation of first case he has in an epidemic of infectious diseases. Yes? The symptomatic disease is exceedingly valuable to the homeopathic physician. Who said that?
Dr. Hanneman.
Dr. H. A. Roberts. So each and every symptom is the most valuable for a physician while dealing with epidemic cases. And in which chapter you will see boric repertory prophylaxis?
General test, yes. Ma'am. General test.
Yes, answer. And name the remedy here for the ill effects of vaccination. And this remedy is very helpful as a prophylactic against smallpox. It breaks as well as diminishes the severity of smallpox. And
Antim Tot.
As a preventive for smallpox.
Antim Tot.
No postulation and never ending one is.
Antim Tot.
No.
Amjalsemium.
Is melandrinum. And this is an interesting thing. Like this is the doctrine of signature part. The workers, those who used to work in copper mines, they never used to get the disease. This epidemic, they never used to suffer from this epidemic disease, while the surrounding people used to suffer. Because of this, people started using copper coins, copper ornaments, copper vessels, and everything. And Hanneman, considering this as an important part, he started treating as the very best preventive against this particular epidemic. What is that epidemic? You have to name the epidemic. This property of copper to produce symptoms exceedingly like those of these.
Cholera or
scarlet fever, madam?
Cholera.
Cholera.
No, no.
Oh, yeah.
I'm a Spanish flu.
No. We are habituated to throw coins, ragi coins or coins in the rivers while we are traveling. I'm giving a clue. What is the reason? It is cholera that and the
rivers. Ma'am, up to Kalra, Kalra was later na in 90s na Kalra. Hanneman is of 1800 na 1700.
But he
Kalra is of 1900 disease. Na.
Successful practitioner who treated cholera with Cupramed. Okay. So coming to the next part of the question, the spirit of this remedy of chemist bears the Rubini's name, Dr. Rubini of Naples, being a homeopath who achieved amazing results in Italy during cholera epidemic. So what is that? Name the medicine. Till date, it is the remedy bears his name. What is that?
Camphor?
Yes. This remedy is called as the spirit of camphor, the Rubini's camphor. It's the right answer. And this is the last part, a very interesting part and an important part, which proves that homeopathy stood to the test of times of all these epidemics through the years and proved itself as an evidence-based scientific system of medicine. And it was recorded, all the stalwarts of homeopaths, they recorded and they paved the way, they guided us so that we can also do the same thing. Now coming to the first question, one of the earliest tenets of homeopathy system was in the treatment of? Was in the treatment of? First, epidemic treated by Dr. Hanneman.
Ma'am, malaria.
Cholera. Cholera.
Out of 180 cases, 178 cases, he treated during the Napoleon War. And next question is, he is the author of Logic of Figures, where he collected all the statistics and compared with the conventional therapies and the homeopathic ones. Who is he?
Kent. Kent, he is madam.
He is not Kent. You can visualize his pic here. He is Dr. Bradford. Thomas Winslet Bradford. We can have a collection and comparison of all these things. And next, he is the first to consider the use of dihydrated and agitated animal parts or products without previous pathogenic experimentation or application of similitude. Who is he? You all know pretty well. We are all well aware of him. After Hahnemann, who is he? To consider the use of diluted and agitated animal parts without any experimentation.
Dr. Kaumudi, we are already almost 25 minutes late. We have to conclude now.
Okay, sir. It's in the last part. Only 3 more questions are there.
Nee, but last part you told 5 minutes back also, na?
Yeah, it's okay, sir. And this is the only remedy in 1918 where in a plant of 8,000 work, there was only one death and they didn't use any aspirin or vaccination. What is the remedy?
Gelsemium.
Arsenic.
Gelsemium.
Yes, gelsemium is the right answer. And he is a great protomedicus of Prussia at the time. And he supported belladonna as a prophylactic, carried so much weight that the Prussian government made its use during scarlet fever in 1838. I think I better give the answers also because the time is running short. Because technical issues, we started late. Is Hooflan. And Dr. George August Hendrik Nolan, he received from the Royal Prussian Academy of Sciences the great silver medal of merit in the treatment of this epidemic of very malignant form. That is scarlet fever.
Scarlet fever.
And Dr. Prussell, he won a gold medal for his achievements with cholera epidemic during France.
Cholera.
He is Joseph Pilte. He embedded his experiences, reflections in a monograph which had an extensive circulation in the West. And this homeopath, where because of him, the London Homeopathic Hospital was converted into cholera hospital. And they were all incorporated in the Blue Book at the instance of the Parliament. Dr. Quinn. And Dr. Joseph Roth, he published a voluminous report which established great superior homeopathic method against this epidemic, that is cholera. And he is an example of recorded benefits of homeopathy. And the results were reported at annual meeting of American Institute of Homeopathy by Dr. Herring. And he is the earliest homeopath in Cincinnati. And during cholera epidemic in 1849, the people crowded at the door and stood in the street because his waiting room was full. He is Dr. Joseph Pilte. And he worked on a troop carrier ship in the World War I. On the way over to Europe, had 81 cases of H1N1. And everyone received homeopathic treatment and all recovered and landed safe. It's a great achievement by Dr. H.R. Roberts. And a successful homeopathic practitioner during scarlet fever with belladonna, his success was so great that many allopathic physicians adopted his treatment protocol and began singing the praises of homeopathic belladonna was Dr. Hahnemann. And he is the author of homeopathy and influenza, chorus of 15 harmony, an article published in the Journal of American Institute of Homeopathy in 1980. What is the influence of pandemic Spanish flu was Dr. Divey. So, we all have a clarity regarding the COVID-19, what to do, and regarding corona and homeopathy. And homeopathy has treated all these which we have gone through all the epidemic years for the last, since the discovery of Hahnemann. So, why not COVID? And after this COVID, we enter into the new world, that is a corona-free world with homeopathic medicines. And we can kick off, it's the time to go for corona. And I wish all a happy 2021, that is annus mirabilis. And thank you. I thank Dr. Emerald for giving me this wonderful opportunity. Dr. Muktinder Singh sir, Dr. V. Kekta sir, and all the CEC members and all the IHPMs and all the participants for your enthusiasm and encouraging me to work more. And my special thanks to Dr. Nitya for her anchoring and scoring. And I think we'll give you the details of the winners after a short while. So Dr. Muktinder Singh sir, as I started a bit late, sorry for the delay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Kaumudi. Your hard work is evident. So you have really worked hard on the subject, and I congratulate the participants, though less, but all, especially I could see Dr. Renuka, Dr. Sanjeev Agarwal, and few were very much attentive and very good answers. So I congratulate you on holding this, though this is not the right platform for such kind of exhaustive works. You have really worked hard. So hope we'll be conducting these kind of quizzes with more preparation, because we intended to hold this in with preparation in the coordination with the college students and form the teams, and then with the team we wanted to hold this quiz, but due to certain technical limitations and the colleges are not in full blow, so we could not conduct. So this was a kind of rehearsal for some future events, and I wish Dr. Kaumudi will keep up the hard work and will be doing even better when we next arrange it even more meticulously. So thank you, Dr. Kaumudi. I, on behalf of IIHP, CEC committee, Dr. Rao sir and Dr. V.K. Gupta sir and all of the CEC committee members, I congratulate you once again. So with this, we end this meeting today. The next meeting, the flyer and the all detail would be shared through social media, and this recording would be uploaded on the YouTube within 2-3 days. So I thank Dr. Sudhanshu Arya for his untiring services towards the homeopathy, and he has made YouTube channel a living channel. So I once again thank our leadership, Dr. Amira Sow, Dr. VK Gupta sir. So with this, we end this meeting today. Thank you for to all the participants, to all the leadership, and once again thanks to Dr. Kaumudi for doing such a hard work. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.